Okay, I'm gonna give this another shot and see if it fixes the frame drop. I'm hoping it does, that there's no lag. Because this is really frustrating. Consider this a test for my Let's Plays, because I still have to figure a bit out, apparently. And I apologize if anybody's coming on and this is lagging out and it's the Super Nintendo, it's a translated ROM. Oh my goodness, it looks like it's lagging again. I'm having technical difficulties though. Yeah, I'm checking it out on the watch page now, and it's not even broadcasting half of what I'm saying here. You know, the last time I was on here, I had the chat working, everything was working great, and then all of a sudden it's,
you know, the last time I was on here,
making me look like a fool.
I had the chat working. I had everything was working great, and then all of a sudden it's,
you know, the last time I was on here,
making me look like a fool.
I had the chat working. I had
okay. I'm gonna attempt to play this game here.
Everything was working great.
And see how it goes. Like I said, this is just a test thing, a test run. I'm hoping it goes well.
Yeah, I'm gonna attempt to play this game here.
Because I'd really like to play the game. Like my original plan was Pure Solar,
test run.
But I couldn't get the ROM to run. I have a Twitch account. That's a good idea, and really I'll probably do that next time. Because
my original plan
when I used Twitch,
solar,
I used Twitch a long time ago
get the ROM to run.
And had no problems whatsoever. And this is
I
my first time kind of messing
it's
around with
idea,
YouTube Live.
And
I'm really not liking it at all.
Because
so,
when I used Twitch,
most likely,
Twitch
yeah,
a long time ago,
Twitch is going to be the way I go next time.
And had no problems whatsoever.
Yeah, I'm sorry. That's
this is my first time kind of messing
my volume was
YouTube
up.
YouTube Live.
It shouldn't echo anymore.
I'm really not liking it at all.
Because
so.
When I use Twitch,
most likely,
Twitch
yeah.
A long time ago.
Twitch is going to be the way I go next time.
All right,
no
so.
Yeah, I'm sorry. That's, let's see.
My volume was up.
Live.
It shouldn't echo anymore.
This is Magic Knight Rayearth. And I believe it was on a Sega CD.
All right, so.
And this is a translated copy of it for the Super Nintendo.
It shouldn't echo anymore.
This is Magic Knight Rayearth. And I believe it was on a Sega CD.
Alright, so.
And this is a translated copy of it for the Super Nintendo.
This is Magic Knight Rayearth. And I believe it was on a Sega CD.
Alright, so.
And this is a translated copy.
Hoping I can move this chat over here where I can actually see it. Oh boy, YouTube is not that great. I can move this chat over here where I can actually see it. Okay, pop out chat, that's what I need. Sorry, just still trying to set this up a little bit. This will hopefully be the only time I have to set this up, because yeah, it's looking like Twitch is the way to go. Alright. Is it still echoing at all? Sorry. Alright. Is it still echoing at all? Alright. I thought I heard a voice.
Alright.
Oh? So I was on earlier, and it was really choppy, and I was trying to talk about the things that I, it is, oh no.
So I was okay. On earlier, and it was really choppy, and I was trying to,
let's mute that, maybe it's, that's probably what it was. I was trying to talk about the new stuff for Rocket Launcher Experience that I put out during the week, and I put out the NES soundtracks and the Nintendo 64 soundtracks. I put 600 for NES, so that completes the NES for me, and I put out 209, I think, for the Nintendo 64. So that also completes the N64 libraries. And both of those are up for download on the Mega Upload site for anyone who wants to grab those now. I also mentioned that if you're not... If you're not a part of the Facebook page or the Twitter page, I will post on those pages the moment that I upload. You don't have to wait for the next video to know what's new. I post it on on those pages. So the moment that I'm done, Sega Saturn, you're right, okay. I knew it was one of those. Yeah. So the moment that I'm done with something, especially the bigger stuff, I will immediately post it up on Twitter. Usually it's Facebook, and then I'm like, oh yeah, I have a Twitter account too. I always forget about my Twitter, and then I'll post it on Twitter. So, gives you a little lead time in front of everyone else to get the stuff. I was being on a field trip. Tokyo Tower. My, what a coincidence. I was at Tokyo Tower also. Wait a minute. I was at Tokyo Tower too. This place doesn't look like it at all. I think that we should introduce ourselves then. And this is where you put in the names, I guess. I guess not. December 12th. So when they introduce themselves, I guess they have to give their blood type and everything, huh? It's important when you introduce yourself. You're the legendary Magic Knights. Mighty Princess Emerald, choose these kids. Look who's talking. You look like you're 10 years old. Actually, I'm 745 years old, and my blood type is B. Are you from here? Where are we? This is Sephiroth. You are the ones destined to become the Magic Knights. You were summoned to this land by Princess Emerald. Yeah, I know. You know what? You know what's funny about that quota thing? When I first started putting stuff up on Mega, it wasn't as bad as it is now. Like, I had to re-download some stuff, magazines or something, and I don't remember having to deal with a quota. And so, I then later, maybe a couple months down the line, I had to re-download music, and I see this pop-up that says that I can't download more than such and such, and I pay for the account, and it won't let me download more than a certain amount at a time, and I'm paying for it. I was like, what the hell? So I'm definitely going to look for a different way to provide my media. I'm short on funds at the moment, so I can't really experiment with things, but near the end of the month, I'm going to come into a little bit of money, so I'll be able to try to find something better. I was going to go with torrent, and it's been brought up to me about torrenting, so it's definitely an option. The only bad thing about torrenting is that I'm constantly adding to my stuff. So it would either have to be a lot of torrents to where I can change them on the fly, or I would have to constantly upload a new 400 gig torrent every time I add something to it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't just pop in new media when I get it. Like, let's say the NES soundtracks, it was 9 gigs. So I can't just throw in 9 gigs worth of NES soundtracks on the fly. I'd have to redo the torrent, the zip file, all that, and then re-host the torrent. And and as much as I add to it constantly, it could be more work than it's worth in the end. So I'm looking to get away from Mega, but I don't know if torrenting is the best solution. Now, as far as torrenting for complete systems, like when I completely finish the NES and get all the artwork and music and everything done, that I can see doing. Archive is something I've been looking into. Like Exodus is hosted on Archive, and that sounds like a really good idea to do that. So I was gonna look into that. But like I said, torrent is an option for the systems that are complete when I'm completely done with them. But as much as I add to and change, you know, I'll look at some artwork and some stuff that I did before and I'm like, I don't like that, you know, and I want to change it out. As much as I do that, it would be a real pain in the ass to torrent. But I'm looking for some other alternative. I really don't like the fact that I think I'm paying $12 a month for my server. FTP would be good, yeah. Yeah, I'd really like to get it on the Emu Movies one, but it's a lot of data. It's right now it's 400 gigs and it's growing. You know, every week I'm adding 10 to 15 gigabytes worth of stuff to it. So it might get a bit out of hand on their FTP. And I don't know the first thing about starting an FTP of my own. So that would definitely be something I'd have to read up on. But I'm looking for something more immediate where I kind of know the process or the process is done for me already. I've never uploaded things for people before. I've never tried to make it's on the Hyperspin one. Yeah, but how much space do they have available? That's the problem. Like, if I approach Circle and say, hey, I got 350 gigabytes of stuff, well, it's almost up to 400 now. 400 gigabytes of stuff, and every month I'm going to need another 40 gigs of space. How would he feel about that? You know, what would he... Is he going to expect... Oh, he does both. I didn't know that. Okay. Yeah, maybe I'll throw Serco a message. If anything, even if he can't... even if he can't put it on his FTP, he might be able to point me in the right direction as to what I can do. I already have platinum. I have the platinum for life on Hyperspin, and then I got the Emu Movies yearly account. So I think the only thing as far as that stuff that I have not gotten yet is the big box from Launchbox, and that'll happen at the end of the month. So it sounds like a new game title. Oh boy. Whatever, now send us back to where we came from. Treasure box. How cheap. It can't be helped. Alright, let's go. The treasure box is inside these woods, right? Inside the LL forest, there are fairies. If they understand your feelings, they will help you. Okay. Take these recovery items. Use them when you feel weak. If you run out of them, come back to me. What do you mean? There's a way to display the videos. Six life cubes. All right. boy. Not even one step and I'm in a fight already. Alright, so, never played this. Never played it on Saturn. But I imagine it's much like every turn-based RPG. Good lord. These things have a bit of hit points. I have a lot to figure out before I do another let's play. Oh, that's probably the magic user and I'm trying to do regular attacks. I have a lot to figure out before I do another let's play, that's for sure, because I need to figure out the streaming. I need to figure out what this echo is, apparently. Live streaming so far the past couple weeks has been a pain in the ass, and but hopefully when I make the switch back to Twitch, that'll fix that problem. Good god, these are the first enemies, and that's... Jeez. Legendary knights have been summoned. Sephiroth is pillar, after all. Then the magic knights are... They're only kids. Is this Power Rangers? There's no way they will become magic knights and resurrect the Mashin. But there is always a chance. True. Pests should be taken care of before they become problems. Of course, my dear Zagato. Okay. I imagine this is a save point. Lucky guess. Quick question, can you guys hear the game on your end? Really? That's interesting. Okay, cool. So, I don't understand. Anybody ever play this for Saturn or Sega? Well, it's only on Saturn. Why the hell do I have magic points, but I can't do magic? It doesn't make any sense. And I have one of these characters hitting for one hit point and missing. So no magic, and she hits for like one hit point. Oh, she's the 41. Okay. The one in the middle is one hit point. I'm hoping that she gets something sometime soon. Don't eat me, don't eat me. Yeah, I'll try something there. What are you saying? We won't eat you. It has wings? Could it be a fairy? What are you afraid of? Please tell us. You're not monsters? If you're not a monster, then what are you? I'm Hikaru. My blood type is O. We're here to get the treasure box inside these woods. If you go between the pink and orange flowers, it will lead you to the treasure box of the LL Woods. Some really awkward pauses in this chat. Between the pink and orange flowers, right? Thank you very much. Be careful of the monsters. Okay. Alright. So 12 magic points. Yeah, nothing on down. Nothing. I guess I gotta find the magic. Sometimes they'll do that. Still buffering? Oh, I broadcast it at 11, and you couldn't even see what I was saying or doing or anything, barely. At least it's better now. I had to decrease the quality of the video and just the bitrate, all kinds of stuff. Now, I should probably grind for experience at this point, because there's that save point that gives you your health back. And normally when I play an RPG like this, I would just spend like 20 minutes at the doorway and grind experience. But I'm not gonna put you guys through that. I'm gonna see what I can do without doing that. I'll tell you, there's some games back when I was a kid that were all about the grind. Dragon Warrior, I remember the most. Spending 2 hours just grinding experience outside the castles. Pink and orange flowers. This place must be what the fairy was talking about. Ah. I hope you're not saying we run into this tree. And it is. A hole opened up. Now we can go on. Ta-da! Alright. Nothing. Well, I don't know this game yet, so I don't know how they hide things, but yeah, I'm a little disappointed because I really, really wanted to play Pure Solar. I was looking forward to that. Actually, since I mentioned it last week, I was looking forward to it. And then I go to load it up, and it says that I tried Fusion because I had family over, and I didn't have much time to prepare for going live tonight. And I just downloaded Fusion really quick and tried to run it in there, and it says that it's too large because it's a new game. You know, if anyone in here doesn't know, and it's a 64 meg cartridge, so yeah, I can tell already it does. It requires a lot. But, hey, finally. I guess it's for the better that it didn't work on the Genesis emulator, because I really want to get it working on the Dreamcast one instead. Get the HD remake, or the HD version. So, I will figure out, how to get that working, and it'd probably be the first thing I do. Yeah, me too. That's a freaking grind fest too at some points. Like, Final Fantasy 1 is literally impossible to beat some of the bosses without spending 30 minutes grinding experience points. About midway through the game, you're stuck grinding experience points. But I remember Dragon Warrior, it stands out the most in my head. It was probably even Dragon Warrior 3. There was one of them that I played a lot of when I was a kid, and it, you play like this guy who owns a shop. Pure Solar for the, it came out for the Genesis. It's a 64 meg cartridge, and it came out for the Dreamcast and the PC, I believe. And it was 2012, I believe it came out. And now it's literally, I don't think you can order it anymore. I don't think they're making any more copies, and the people that have the copies, especially the Dreamcast copy, are charging an arm and a leg. But luckily the ROM is available. It's just getting it to run. You know, I'm going to stop taking these detours and go straight. Look at that. Yeah, there's a grind spot, if there ever was one. Watching chat, almost walked right by that treasure chest. Yeah, early on in Final Fantasy, actually the grind is never really that difficult in Final Fantasy, and once you get ahead by a substantial amount, you're ahead the whole game. But if you don't want to spend the whole time, okay, if you don't want to spend the whole time grinding before each level, let's say, then you have to do it all at once, and that's a pain. This must be the treasure box. What gave it away? Because it's the treasure box? You found the LL treasure box. What do you know? Let's go home. I hope there's some magic spells in that treasure box. Excuse me. It looks like the stream is going better now since I lowered the quality. I'm not happy about having to lower the quality to get it to work, but at least it's streaming for me, and that's the important part. You seem to have found the treasure box. Now, you promised to tell us how to get home. The way to return to your world is to become the Magic Knights and save this... What the fuck? Oh, it's a simple task, huh? Magic Knights, before I came here, I think I heard a voice. I heard it also. I think it said, save this world. How convenient. Legendary. Magic Knights. You know, something tells me... Like I said, I've never played the Saturn version, but something tells me this is a supposed 100% translated edition of the game. Something tells me the translation is a bit off in this. Just a little bit. Sephiroth is in danger when the pillar Princess Emerald was kidnapped. Monsters started appearing and rampaging the lands. What is the pillar? Princess Emerald supports the peace of Sephiroth with her prayer and strong will. On Sephiroth, the strength of your will becomes your true strength. But... she's kidnapped? Who did it? The second strongest next to Princess Emerald, the priest Zagato. Sephiroth is currently in danger. That wish has summoned you here. Then if we save this land, becoming the Magic Knights, then the princess's wish will be granted, allowing you to return. But first, to prepare for the upcoming battles, I will give you some equipment and magic. Come on. This is really starting to feel like a game. Now for... Yes, thank you. There's the magic. I shall give one to each of you. Magic? Except... Am I the only one that finds this dialogue funny? It's so ridiculous. And these girls are 14. Stop it with these pictures. I'm going to get in trouble. Ah, so you are the ones summoned to be the Magic Knights. The magics have chosen you. The treasure box had magic in it. What is your name? Hikaru Shidu, and my blood type is B. Okay, Hikaru, can you feel it? The power inside that was never there? I can feel it. It burns inside my chest, so she gets fire magic. I can sense some words coming to me. That is your magic. Yeah, that would be nice. Some FMV slipped in here. It's Zagato's henchman. Zagato, the bad guy you just talked about? Teach me magic too. There's no time left. Ah. Oh, good God. Ride this. I'll remain and hold off the enemy. Okay. Hikaru, hurry. I didn't catch your name yet. Oh my God. Why is everybody so hung up on names? I'm Guru Clef. To guide and protect you was my promise to Princess Emerald. Now go. In the Forest of Silence, you'll find Presia. Oh my God, look at the way that thing flies. It's like it's about to crash. Meet Presia, get weapons, and Mokona. It has been a while, Guru Clef. Alcyon, I taught you magic to guard Princess Emerald, not to bring Sephiroth to danger. Sorry, but I don't have time to talk. If I fought you toe-to-toe... Well, whatever happened to hand-to-hand? I'd have no chance of winning, so I'll leave him to fight you while I kill those girls. Alcyon. Monster says, Graw. Monster says, Gya. Following will be easy, but if those kids can't defeat Alcyon, there is no way they can revive the Mashin to become the Magic Knights. Their true adversary is much stronger than her. Magic Knights, overcome your obstacles and save Sephiroth. Okay. Clef. Where's the never-ending story music? He'll be all right. He was so confident. I'm sure he's as strong. But we can't... Now, okay, here's... This is kind of funny because it looked like it was having a spaz attack when it was taking off, but here it's flying in the middle of the sky and not moving at all. It's just kind of... It looked like it was catapulted. But we can't just leave him behind like this. Let's go back. No, Clef wants us to save Sephiroth. That is why he helped us escape. It would all mean nothing if we go back and get killed. Okay, let's go. Okay, I'll check that out next time I try it. Yeah, I think that's the problem, because it's an MD ROM. Although I don't have any problems on my arcade running MD instead of GEN, I think that's the issue with this ROM, is that it's actually a Mega Drive game. Because it specifically says, I don't think this is a Genesis / 32X game. Hello, young knights. You really are only kids. It's a bit cruel, but you're going to have to die here. Dodging my spells, try this one. Okay. Let's see. So only one got magic. Alright, magic. And it's fire, like I thought. Better be strong. Go boom. That's nice. That works. That thing that I was riding was. That's what I was standing on there. It got a lot bigger for the battle. Like we were fighting on its neck. We did it. But I wonder how far until the forest where Prescia is. Huh? What's happening? Oh my god, what's wrong with this thing? It ran out of fuel. I'm just waiting for a big explosion when it hits the ground. Where is this Prescia's house? Roar. It's dead. I don't know, but I'm glad it didn't disappear while flying. Anyway, let's ask around this village for where Prescia might be. Alright. So, the first actual town. Let's see what stupid people live here. Other than magic power restored. Save your game, of course. So, not like... Oh, wow, you literally get no buttons for inventory or anything out here? Oh, the start button? No. Nothing. Oh, what did I press? Okay. Something. Okay, why? Alright. The Sphere of Light. Touch it and you'll be magically healed. Remember that. And old woman says, I'm worried about Gramps lately. He's been having disturbed sleep. I wonder if he is okay. How long will these days of uncertainty continue? So I'm guessing there's really nothing hidden in boxes or barrels or anything in this game. That looks like a chest. But it's not. Nope. Okay. Why is everybody old here? Old man, it's nice to be young. If I was another 500 years younger, I would fight the monsters too. Okay, so it's a town of elderly people. Never mind. This looks like an inn or something. He should have told me it was a creator, Prescia. But why can't I talk to her over the counter? In the eastern woods, you can't use magic. So magical creatures can't live there either. So that is why the bird that brought us here disappeared. Okay. It's quite the ponytail. East of here, there's a creator named Priscilla. Yeah, I got it. Come on. People who make weapons and armor. Super. That's where I was already. What is this guy doing? Without liquor, I can't go on in this world. Okay. Not a kid's game, I'm guessing. I got absolutely no valuable information from this town. I don't believe I missed anything. I mean, obviously I go east, but... yeah. Nothing of value. Okay. So let's head east. Normally this is also where I would check a walkthrough or something, just to make sure I'm going the right direction, because I don't like to walk out of my way. But there's a game on the Super Nintendo that I did that with when I was younger called Breath of Fire, where I got stuck so many times on that game because it's not very clear in some points where you have to... oh my god, with this one freaking hit point. It's not very clear in some points where you have to go. So there were many instances where I just wandered in that game. I think I hit max level in that game long before I was ever even close to the end of the game. I don't even think I beat it. Breath of Fire. And I have the cartridge now, too. I just haven't played it yet, again. I get some of my games with the intention of playing them eventually and never get to it, unfortunately. Holy hell. What is going on here? This is Magic Knight Rayearth. It's a translated game for the Super Nintendo. I really should put that in the title. I should edit the title of the live stream. But I wasn't sure what I was going to play at first, so that's why I didn't put it there. Okay. Ah, shit. Oh my god, there's three of them. Okay. I was hoping it was like Final Fantasy where you could press down and it hits all of them. Unfortunately, it's not. Mm-hmm. So if I got this right, oh, it's three magic points to use fire. Okay, never mind. I assumed it was you could only use fire three times. Wasn't Final Fantasy 1 like that, where you only had a certain amount of times you can use a spell before until you slept and got the spells back? I know the older, like Eye of the Beholder and stuff like that was like that, where you had to rest and learn your spells, but pretty sure Final Fantasy 1 was like that as well. Or am I thinking of a different game? Ok, God, these fights take too long. I'm doing something wrong here. I must be. I missed a weapon shop or something, I don't know. Am I even getting gold when I kill things I don't even notice? Yeah, that's what I thought. Jesus. Red bolt. Okay, I don't even see anything about gold. What RPG? The one that I tried to play. Pure Solar. Unfortunately, I'm playing this. Well, not unfortunately. This is a good game, and I know it's a good game. I've never played it, but I know from hearsay and from, you know, reviews and stuff that it's a good game. There's a lot of mainstream RPGs out there that I could suggest, but you know, most of those have been played. Chrono Trigger, Earthbound, Final Fantasy 3, 2, all of those. The Dragon Warrior games are good. It all depends on what kind of experience you're going for. If you're going for Super Nintendo or NES, or you want something newer, you know, there's thousands. There's probably 100,000 different RPGs to pick from out there. My overall favorites. I plan to do a video actually on my top RPGs of all time, because I love role-playing games. It's going to take a while for me to decide what those are, but I would say my top favorites, I would put Final Fantasy III. I can give you my top five, but I can't give them to you in the order of the top five, so, because that's a tough one. But I'd say Final Fantasy III, Legend of Dragoon on the PlayStation, a choice between Chrono Trigger and Secret of Mana, because the gameplay was very similar, I would have to go with Secret of Mana. So Final Fantasy III, Legend of Dragoon, Secret of Mana. These battles take way too long, by the way. Two more. I have all my RPGs behind me. Dragon Warrior 3 on the NES, and then this is a tough question to narrow it down. No, I'm not going to say Final Fantasy 7. I'll get back to you on the fifth one when I think of a good one to take that place. And no, I'm not thinking Earthbound either. You know, I started going east, but I changed my mind. I'm just going to kind of walk around and see what's out here. Ugh. Pufferfish. I'm probably going to get my ass kicked going too far here. I don't know though, does Secret of Mana actually count as an RPG, or is that more Zelda-ish? Is that more like an action-adventure RPG? I don't know if that really counts as a full-on RPG, or Chrono Trigger. Pretty sure they're action, or they're adventure, type games more than anything else. They do have the aspect of spells and upgrading your armor and stuff like that, but you know, so does Zelda 2. I mean, and that's as far from an RPG as any other side-scrolling. Oh, I got it. Number 5 on my list, if it counts, because it's also an action. I haven't played it in so long, but I remember it being one of my favorites as a kid. Monster Land 3, Wonder Boy 3, The Dragon's Trap, I believe it's called. OST? What's OST? Are you talking about real-time strategy? Like StarCraft and stuff? I'm so gonna die. I don't even know where I'm going right now. I'm not following you. Original soundtrack games. Are you asking me what's my favorite music from the games? Because those are easy selections. If you've never heard the music from Intelligent Cube on PlayStation, do yourself a favor and listen to it. Intelligent Cube has a great soundtrack. Now, it's not great if you don't like classical soundtracks, but most of the soundtracks from the PS1 era and up are classical soundtracks, so Intelligent Cube is definitely up there in one of my top favorites. I like God of War. I like if you're talking 8-bit, Journey to Silius, I can listen to that whole soundtrack. The music is fantastic in that game. Suikoden, whatever you call it, has a great soundtrack. There's so many, but I would say those are the ones that I actually listen to and turn back to. You know, there's the favorites like One Winged Angel, Castlevania Symphony of the Night, definitely some good tracks on there. There's some favorites that I'll put on once in a while, but I mean, rarely do I come across a soundtrack that I can sit down, turn on, and listen to the entire thing all the way through. And those soundtracks that I mentioned they fit that bill. I can listen to them start to finish. And actually, Intelligent Cube, I'll listen to start to finish. And I'll actually want to restart it from the beginning again. It's a really, really good soundtrack. And you wouldn't think so, because it's kind of an underground game. It's a niche puzzle game. I mean, it's a really good game too. I mean, don't get me wrong, the game is fantastic. If you like puzzle games, that game is fantastic. But yeah, I mean, okay, eventually I'm going to go the right direction here. It keeps stopping me, like I try to go... Mega Man 2, yeah, that's definitely good. I've listened to those quite a bit. Banjo-Kazooie's not bad. Personally, for my taste, there's probably only one or two songs on there. But see, when I was a kid, I never played Banjo-Kazooie as much as maybe a lot of other people. I was really big into RPGs and puzzle type games and stuff like that. So I think the most action game that I played when I was younger had to be Castlevania 2. Other than that, well, Mario Brothers as well, I mean. But everybody's played Mario Brothers and Mario 3. But as far as the Nintendo 64, when that first came out, I owned only a handful of games. I owned Mario Kart, Mario 64, and WCW NWO, one of those games. And played the hell out of all three of them and never really needed anything else. Honestly, those three games gave me everything that I wanted from the system. Nintendo 64 has such a good lineup of games that, you know, some people hate on the N64 and say it's a bad system, but in my opinion, you could pick three games from that system and they will last you a long ass time, because their games, they may not have had as many games as any other systems, but they were quality, they were top notch games, you know. They were the stuff that they put out, not all of it, don't get me wrong, it has its shit games on there as well, but there's a lot of quality in N64 games. You know, you can take Mario 64 and you will keep coming back to it. You just keep on coming back. Like Mario Brothers for the NES is a classic game. You know, you can't deny its history, but when you try to sit down and play it, it doesn't have the same, you know, glow as it used to have. It's not the same game anymore, you know. You lose interest quickly, you know. Okay, it's definitely east and across that bridge. So, hey, the worst thing that happened just now is I leveled up some. It's just not the same game. But I'll tell you, you pop in Mario 64, at least from my perspective, you throw in Mario 64, it is the same game that it was back then. Exactly the same. And it's just as fun. You throw in Mario Kart 64 when you got friends over, which I did. I actually had a retro gaming party not that long ago. And the last game on the list for the competition was to play Mario Kart. And it's still just as fun as it was back in the day. And not many systems you can say that about. I love the NES. I love the Super Nintendo. Don't get me wrong. I have a lot of games from those systems. But they're not the same as they used to be. You know, you could sit down and play a game that you played when you were a kid, but it just does not grab your attention. You know, some people it does. Don't get me wrong. This is just me speaking from my perspective, but if I had the opportunity to be in any game, what would it be and why? Any console? Frankly, most of these games are kind of scary. I don't know if I'd want to be in any game. To be in a game. You know what game I would want to be in? When you get drunk, that's probably pretty awesome. If I had to pick a game to be in, it would be Maniac Mansion. Because that game just seems like it would be a blast to go through. Yeah, it's scary as shit, but it seems like to be in that would be a blast. Plus, you got your friends there doing it with you, you know, and yeah, definitely Maniac Mansion. I should check out these new spells that I keep getting. Oh shit, there's something up there. Okay. So that is where I will go. And I gotta be careful because I'm pretty sure, oh damn, I'm pretty sure like any other RPG, if I stray too far, I'm gonna get my ass whooped by some weird looking creature. You know, I'll tell you about that Pokemon Stadium when you get drunk thing. When I was in my early 20s, mid-20s, I used to have friends over every single weekend and get drunk, party, do other things that I probably shouldn't have done. And it was fun. But I don't do that anymore, unfortunately. Now I have kids, settled down, kind of. I look back on it sometimes and wish that I could do those things again, occasionally. But, oh well, you know. You eventually get too old for it. I've been so drunk one time, and other things. But I was so drunk one time where I was crawling around my friend's house, and like, everybody's asking me, are you okay, are you okay? I'll be honest with you, I was high as fuck. And I was drunk, so... Are you okay? Are you okay? And I just could not even... I didn't even know where I was anymore. And then other times, I played this thing called a dollar game, where you take the last three digits on a dollar bill's serial number, you draw a random dollar, take those digits, and you have 10 bottles set up with numbers all along them, and you mix those three numbered bottles into one shot, and you take the shot. And I was mixing some crazy stuff together, and I was so drunk, I remember everybody's like, hey, we're gonna go out and get some breakfast, you know, it's 4 or 5 in the morning, you wanna come with? And I'm laying in my bed eating out of a loaf of bread with a stomach ache. You know, I can't, sometimes I can handle my liquor, sometimes I can't, and I just kind of escaped that lifestyle, because more often than not, I couldn't handle my liquor. Especially when I mixed it with other things, you know, plants and stuff. This could be Priscilla's house. It took us long enough to get here. Excuse me. Anybody home? Looks like nobody's home. Should we look inside? Excuse me. Sorry about that. Yes, I do. My kids love to play video games, and they love the arcade machine. My youngest is 5 years old, and I wake up at about 6 a.m. in the morning, and I come in here and I start either editing a video or getting more media, whatever I'm doing, and this is at 6 in the morning, and he'll wake up at about 7:30. He'll come straight in the room. I'll say, hey, good morning. And he'll say, good morning. He'll climb up in the stool and go straight to the GameCube games and load up Mario Kart. Double Dash. Every time. He plays Mario Kart Double... At 5 years old, he plays Mario Kart Double Dash. He likes to play Super Monkey Ball. 1 or 2. He plays the Lego games on there. I play Skylanders with my kids a lot. I play Disney Infinity. We just got Lego Dimensions because around, Christmas time, it was at Target. It was like $30 for the whole set. And we were like, hey, why not get it, you know, we'll just pick it up. We got enough of these Toys to Life things. I swear, all together with Amiibo, Skylanders, Disney Infinity, we probably got like 500 figurines. So it was literally a choice we had to make. $30 was a damn good price, but we had to make that choice because do we really want to get more figurines? It was not should we buy it, it's do we want to get into another line of toys? But we decided to co-op all the time. I try not to play games where I'm playing against... Oh, look at that. People are popping up on the window. I try not to play games where I'm playing against the kids because it's hard for me to lose and it's hard for them to win. Let's put it that way. And I don't want to damage any self-esteem by beating them, especially the 5-year-old. He gets really sad when he loses a game, so I try not to do that. He'll be playing Mario Kart. and he'll get like 8th place or something. He's really good at it, but when he gets like 8th or 9th place, he puts his head down and he's like, I didn't want to be 8th place or 9th place or whatever. And so it's better for the self-esteem just to try to stray away from that stuff. Favorite and worst play on arcade co-op? Oh boy. Favorite and worst games? Well, co-op, arcade, hands down, Ninja Turtles. Hands down. Worst? I don't know. I don't really put any games that I don't think are good on my arcade system. I actually handpick every single game. Yeah, you know what? I had the same... It's that family love, man. I had the same thing with my brother, my older brother. And we used to play... Oh, man. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Tournament Fighters on the Super Nintendo. And I used to whoop him every time. And he would get so mad. He got so mad. And I don't understand why when you're kids... I never got mad if I lost. I never got mad. I knew when to get up and walk away or when to take a break or whatever. But he just... He has this rage problem where he just... He would literally... He would make noises and shit. Like, gee, slow down. You know, it's just a game. And as far as Killer Instinct, it's funny, I was actually really good at Killer Instinct in the arcade. Like, really, really good. Like, making people waste their quarters. Good. But Killer Instinct Gold, I could not get the hang of it. It's, like, different on the Nintendo 64 when you're using a controller and stuff. Which is why I was so happy when I built my arcade last year and put Killer Instinct on there, because here I finally have it all over again. And I can school people who come over. Nobody's home. Should we look inside? It opened, but nobody seems to be home. Is it okay for us to enter? Let's go inside. Somebody might be home. You know what? I will tell you a worst co-op game to play for me. It's... the Lego games, because my youngest loves the Lego games, but when you're playing two players with a 5-year-old, they want to do their own thing. You know, playing co-op on Skylanders, it's a bit different. It's hard to explain, but on these Lego games, like, they can actually leave the screen and kill you. Like, if they get too far away, the screen will shift and kill you. And he thinks that's the funniest thing. When he makes that screen shift and sees my Lego guy burst into pieces, he just starts cracking up. And it's hard to deal with, you know, he's my son and I love him and all, but it's hard to deal with a 5-year-old who's laughing at you because you're dying, you know? It's hard to explain that. But as for worst co-op, I would say definitely the Lego games. You know, it's really unfortunate that this freaking chat will not... Oh, you know what? I'm gonna see... Because I want to get the chat to show up in this window. Yeah, it's a game for kids. I keep telling myself that, too. Let's see if this works. Boom! Okay, finally, holy cow. There we go. Problem solved with the chat. I should have done that in the beginning. Alright, so in this game, from what I'm seeing, there's not very many secrets. Like, it's pretty straightforward. Even the chat is extremely straightforward. It doesn't mess around. It tells you exactly where you have to go, even though I wandered around for a while. There's no chests, no boxes, no everything. Look, it's a boom, straight to the end, like where I have to be. Oh, no, never mind. That's not where I have to be. Misjudge that. It looked like a goal. But, I mean, there's no... I hate to say it, but there's no challenge to it yet. Even the enemies, they might take a little while to kill. It's still the fact that they're not, like, putting me in any danger. But I'll see how it goes when I... Okay, I gotta get over there. I guess I just walk over there, huh? Yeah, you know what? I have my videos of the top 50 games to put on your arcade cabinets, but I have a lot of people who comment on those and say, oh, you're missing this game, or why is that game on there, and stuff like that. I think they're misconstruing exactly what I'm trying to accomplish with those videos. It's not a top 10, it's not a top 20. I'm not trying to do that. What I'm trying to do is point out what games are best for an arcade cabinet. Now, I've thought already many times that I should make a separate series on my channel for what I believe are the top 10s of each system. And not necessarily having anything to do with arcade cabinets, but just in their own right, on the NES, on the Super Nintendo, what I feel are the top 10 games. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to do that, starting with the top RPGs. I'm actually going to name off the top... It's going to be a huge video, which is why it's going to take a while, but I'm going to name off the top 100 RPGs of all time. And that's something big I'm actually working on now. So, it should be an interesting video. It's difficult enough to make a top 50 video, but in this one I'm actually going to label them with what system they're on and so on and so forth, and it's going to be huge, but just takes time. That's all. But definitely I've been thinking about, you know, personal top countdowns if you're actually playing the system, what they would be. Somebody's here. They are crying, I'm guessing. Those are tissues. Are you Priscilla? Clef told us to... Oh my god, it's Pikachu. It's Raichu. Oh no, looking down at the picture at the bottom, that is... not. Oh, thank you for subscribing. Poo. He says poo, and then he captures me in a cage. And there's Priscilla. Oh, ho, ho, oh, oh. Oh, ho, oh. I finally got you, Makona. Now I got you for all the mischief you have done. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Okay, I really don't understand how she's trying to say that, but... Poo. Huh? Poo-poo. Then who's in the cage? You're the ones that have been raiding my house. No. Poo-poo. What is flying off of this thing? Poo-poo. Is it not... Okay. Is that like a giant egg-shaped toilet and it's throwing toilet paper to the side? What is going on? Milken, let us out of here. But we did enter without permission. It's her fault for not locking the door. Oh, that's sound logic. The plan is to stream every Saturday, yes. As mentioned earlier, I'm going to look back into Twitch. So it's not going to broadcast over YouTube. So my subscribers from YouTube may not see it. I suggest like to subscribe to my Twitter or my Facebook, and I'll put on there when I'm. I didn't do it tonight because tonight was more of a test run, but I'll post to those when I'm gonna go live. But the plan is every Saturday night at 11 Central Time, Central Standard Time. And if you're wondering about what time that means, right now it is 12:52 a.m. my time. And I started 2 hours ago, but the first, like, 30 minutes was kind of wasted. We're not locking the door, and nobody came when we yelled. The lock was specially made by Clef. Oh, they have, like, channel videos, intro videos and stuff now. See, it's been a while since I was on Twitch. Maybe they always did that, and I just never noticed it. But I really need to update my Twitch account. Inhabitants of Sephiro wouldn't be able to open it. That only means... it's the Magic Knights. She looks like, what's her name? Sailor Moon, the little one. Welcome, Legendary Magic Knights. I have been told by Clef to give you weapons. Weapons? I am the Master Creator, Persia. Making weapons and armor is my job. Thank you. But... I didn't bring my wallet. I do have some candy. Good girl, this will be enough. So she works for candy. Follow me and I'll hand you your weapons. How about you hand me the weapons and then I'll follow you? Now, take the weapons you feel most fit for yourself. Thank you, Persia. I didn't give you those weapons. I'm only letting you borrow them while you... Oh, man. Then I'm only letting you borrow the candy while you go search for the metal for your own weapons. Metal? The Magic Knight's weapons are made from the... legendary metal escudo. Is this okay? Is this a like a Spanish game or a Hispanic game or some type? The names seem very Spanish. Does anybody know? Which is set to grow with its wielder. Weapons made of escudo are the key to revive the Mashin. I don't really understand, but we'll get the metal for you, and for Clef too. Now, I'm wondering if this is like... because sometimes you'll find ROMs where the games... This game, Magic Rayearth. I'm wondering if it's like a... no, it's all Japanese. Oh, okay. Alright. Good luck, Escudo can be found in the Spring of Eterna. Others who have gone there never came back. Oh. But you're the Magic Knights. I'm sure you'll be fine. Really? Poo-poo. I received Makona from Guru Clef. He'll come in handy if you take him along. poo. Makona joined your party. Let's go. Did she actually tell me which way to go? In order to... Okay. You have to go through the Forest of Silence. You can't use items nor magic in there, so be careful. Makona will know the way there. Thank you for everything, Priscilla. Lafarga, I have finished making your weapon. But you can only borrow it. Thanks, now I have something to fight Zagato with. With Zagato? No, Zagato with. Lafarga is the princess's bodyguard. Lafarga, these are the summoned magic knights. I heard about the magic knights of legend. And you're saying these kids are them? Well, you won't be needed. I will defeat Zagato. How rude. Even as the best swordsman in Sephiro, I doubt he can win against Zagato. Zagato is that powerful? He's strong, and only the magic knights could save Sephiro. That is a lot of responsibility. Promise to bring back the escudo. I'll make you the best weapons. Let's go. Good luck. Okay, I'm gonna take a quick AFK, guys. I'll be right back in just a few minutes. Okay. Sorry about that. I am back. Now, what do I think about Dragon Quest? If I'm not mistaken, Dragon Quest is the Dragon Warrior series, isn't it? It's just the Japanese version. I know they had more Dragon Quest games than Dragon Warrior. Yeah, I have played Dragon Warrior 1 through 4 on the NES. I thought they said that this thing was going to show me which way to go. He hasn't done squat so far. I've played 1 through 4. And I've heard a lot of good things about 8 from one of my friends on Facebook. But I have yet to play 8 on the PS2. But that's my extent with Dragon Warrior. I've always wanted to play 4 and 5. I mean 5 and 6. I haven't heard anything of a 7. I don't know if that was only a Japanese release or what, but this is not the right way. My knowledge is not very extended when it comes to Dragon Warrior. Just the first few of them. Especially 3. I played the hell out of Part 3. In Part 3, I loved the fact that you... Oh, shit, there's something. I loved the fact that you can... I think I'm going the wrong way. That you play different roles. You know, you play the shop, the guy who wants to open a shop, and you play... It sort of was a precursor to, I think, games like Suikoden. I don't want to mispronounce that name, because there might be people who look up to that game and watch this video and hate me because I mispronounced it. But I think it was a precursor to games like that, where you have... Oh, there we go. Where you have multiple characters who join forces and eventually defeat the bad guy. You know, only Suikoden took it to a different level, of course. But I think it started with that, with the Dragon Warrior franchise. So, yes, other games had where you meet new members of your party and they join your party and they talk about their backstories you play and stuff like that. Yes, that's pretty much a staple with RPGs. But Dragon Warrior 3 was different. You didn't meet them until after you played through their backstory. And I always thought that was just an amazing way to play out the game. And being on the NES, it was a lot of information for those NES carts back in the days. That was just a huge game. So I have a lot of love for Dragon Warrior 3. I will say that. And I'm probably going to kick myself because I was a kid the last time I played it, so I don't remember if I'm referring to Dragon Warrior 3 or 2 or 4, but one of those, and I have all 4 of them, one day I'll pop it in and just to verify which one it was, but one of those is probably one of the better RPGs that I've played. It's a good series, and I have every intention to eventually play Part 8, because my friend swears by it. He says it is the best RPG he's ever played, so I will check that out one day. I just remembered something very important. Huh? What do we do when night falls? We can't sleep out here with all the monsters roaming around. My, you're right. Let's ask Makona. I bet he says poo-poo. Makona, we want to rest, but where can we? Hey, what do you know? He said poo-poo. He turns into a tent. No, he created a safe spot for me. This is great, Makona. It's something like a tent. Okay. Poo. It even has pajamas and toothbrushes. No, I never played Shining Force. You know, when I was young, honestly, now I play a lot of games that I never played when I was a kid. I didn't have it very good when I was a kid. We had systems, but it was basically only what my grandmother got for us. And we only saw my grandmother maybe 3 times a year. So we had, my parents had bought me an Atari 2600, and we had maybe 5 games for that. And then my grandmother gave us her, she had a Nintendo there, so when me and my brother or my cousins came over, we'd have something to play. Well, we eventually talked her into giving it to us to bring home. And we had Mario Brothers 3. We used to borrow Ninja Turtles and stuff from the people down the... I digress. But anyways, we didn't have a very large selection of games when I was a kid. And we definitely did not have a Genesis. When I was in my early teens, I had a friend from school, and I would go to his house, and he had a Genesis, and he had a TurboGrafx-16, and he even had the little handheld TurboGrafx-16. And I would play Genesis there. And the most I played on Genesis, I think we played Toe Jam and Earl. We played... He had Streets of Rage 2, which was just... I mean... It's still an awesome game, but back then it was fucking mind-blowingly good. I mean, when you're a kid and that is top of the line at the time, Streets of Rage 2 was just amazing. So we played that a lot, and, you know, some TurboGrafx-16 games. But now I have the opportunity to get those games because I'm an adult, and... play those games that I've always wanted to play, and Shining Force is on the list of games for me to get. I have not picked it up yet, though. I think there's like, geez, there's like 4 of them on Genesis, isn't there? 4 on Genesis, and then there's a Shining Force CD. Yeah, you know, I hear a lot about them. Aren't they like futuristic type, It has the same look as like Final Fantasy Mystic Quest, only better, of course. And they're like futuristic type games, or am I thinking the wrong thing? I'm thinking Phantasy Star, sorry. Phantasy Star is another game that I haven't played. Now, I collect Nintendo, Super Nintendo, Nintendo 64, and PS2 games right now. And I am on the cusp of completing the games that I'm after. And then I hit up Genesis. So, okay. Well, then I'll hit up Genesis. And Shining Force is definitely on the list of games that I'm going to get. Yeah. Am I mistaken? There's like 3 or 4 of them on the Genesis. I know that. Really? So is it like a Suikoden type game? Okay, yeah. Yeah, and I love those kind of games. I like variety, like Suikoden brought to the table, it was able to take over 100 characters, and it didn't make you pick any characters for a certain point in the game. You could go back to your base and take whoever you want, and that was always awesome. And there was so much playability because you can always pick a team and just go out and level them up if you want one day, or progress in the game if you want another day. And it seemed like it was like an MMORPG almost, in a way. I don't know if that's a good comparison, but you know, there's always something to do in that kind of game. So yeah, I'm sure I would love Shining Force. And of course I have the ROMs for it, but I'm kind of silly. When I play a RPG or something, I like to play them on the actual system. Like, I could sit here and play Mario or whatever, on a ROM and it's no big deal. But when I play an RPG, I want to sit down on my CRT television with the actual system and play with the actual controller and get into the RPG, you know. So, unless I'm doing this, of course I'm emulating here. It's not my preference. I would have much rather ran a capture device through my Retron 5 and played off of that, but unfortunately I don't have a capture device and my Retron 5 broke. So it was working fine, and then all of a sudden I turned on one day and the lights came on but no picture, and it just stopped working. But yeah, I would have to actually own the games, so I'm kind of waiting on some games. I don't want to ruin them by playing a ROM. I want to wait until I actually have them in front of me to play them. And I mean, I have a Genesis, I have, if any of you have seen my room tour, I have all the systems to play them on. It's just I don't have the games, so eventually I get the games, and yeah, I know that they have those carts where you can load them up with the ROMs and put them in the actual system, and I've actually thought about those, you know, to play some of those more expensive games. Like, I want to be able to play Splatterhouse on the actual Genesis. I want to be able to play, you know, some of these pricey-ass games. You know, nobody's made of money unless you're actually made of money, I guess. And I'm definitely not. But, I'm definitely going to check out Shining Force as soon as I pick them up. I know the next games on my list, though, the original Toe Jam and Earl for the Genesis, Dungeons and Dragons, I think it's, I don't remember, I think it's Eternal Sun on there, or something like that. I have a empty case for it, but I don't have the game. And then, Wonder Boy 3, The Dragon's Trap. Those are the three games that I'm going to pick up next for Genesis. But I have a list. There's quite a few that I'm going to get. But Nintendo comes first. I had to, unfortunately, I got set back on my collecting a little bit. I've never heard of Landstalker. What is that? I got set back on my collecting a little bit because last year I had to, Okay, awesome, Gonzo. Thanks for joining in. Yeah, last year I had to kind of sell off a few games to pay for the kids' Christmas presents, but, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. We didn't foresee us having enough to pay for the presents, so I wound up selling my, Mega Man 1 through 6 for NES and my Chrono Trigger. It hurt, but in the end it actually felt pretty good because I was able to get a decent amount of money for it and get a decent amount of presents. So, has pajamas and toothbrushes. Feels just like home. This isn't a hotel. Hey, there's a notebook here. I wonder if we're supposed to write our names in it when we check in. I don't think that's it. Then what is it used for? I have an idea. Let's keep a diary in this notebook. And what would that do? If we keep a diary, then we can save what we have done so far. Right, let's do it before we sleep. I'm getting sleepy now. Then let's hit the sack for the night. Health and magic power restored. Alright. Let's go defeat Zagato now. Yeah, right. Can't even use magic. Well, which way should we go? Pooh? Which way to the Spring of Eterna. Pooh? Maybe he doesn't know. That's not what's supposed to happen. Let's go back to Persia's. And I can't. The entrance disappeared. Why, this really is a strange world. Anyway, let's go. We won't get any escudo by waiting here. I agree. Great. Okay, how many times did he get to attack me now? I understand that it said I was surprised, but... I'm really curious. I haven't seen any money yet in this game. Oh, okay, duh. I guess I'm just not paying attention. 100 gold right there. Right in my face. Okay, big dude. Oof. Okay, I don't actually speak Portuguese. I use a translating program to do that when the comments are made. Only thing I understand from that is what program do you use to organize? And I'm lost. Feed me a monster. We have to beat him to go on. Fight the monster? Sure, in just a second. Oh, what program? Okay, gotcha. It is XSplit. Yes, I will fight the monster. Attack! You challenge the monster. Yeah, it's XSplit, broadcaster. Oh, I probably should have started using... Oh, I can't use magic here. Crud. I can't use items either. Oh, I forgot. Well, let's hope that this is a really easy monster, I guess. Man, all that getting lost and stuff is really paying off. No. I want to go back and save again. Alright, we won. Yep. Grrr. Another monster. His ally? Wait. Huh? Who are you? Why are you wandering around these parts? This isn't a girl's playground. Pooh. Pooh. McCullen's friendly with him. I don't think he's so bad. Until we see proof, we shouldn't lower our guard. I agree with Umi. I am Fu Huji, and my blood type is A. May I know what your name is? I'm Fario. I'm about to head for Eterna. What? The scooter is what we're going to get, right? If he gets it first, will there still be enough for us? I have an idea. Mr. Fario, do you know the way to Eterna? In this forest, no magic can be used. The exit has to be found by yourselves. We know the exit. I don't mind showing you. Really? But in exchange, please show us the way to Eterna. Alright, I understand. You're welcome. Glad to be of assistance. There you go. Okay, let's work together on this one. Great, Fu. You're really intelligent. Now, which way do we go? Well, Pooh. Makona. The direction which Makona's light shines is the exit. Let's go then. Let me save again first. Fario joined your party. Yes. I'll tell you one thing I did not test. If this is actually saving the file. But I guess I can check in the folder. Because that would kind of suck to do all this and then have to load it up later and find out my file's erased. But there should be a SRC, I think it is. Good God. Whenever I find something to spend this gold on, I'm gonna have a ton. Okay, where's the light? Where did that light go? It just kind of disappeared. But I think I'm going the right way. It looks like an exit to me. Yep. There's a presence here, eh? It's the dude. Out. An ambush. A monster attacks. He don't stand a chance. 2 damage and it's a crushing attack. Some of these fights are just really pointless because I'm doing all this damage, yeah, but I'm not really getting hurt. There's no real danger of dying. Like, I don't really understand the point of it. I mean, I'll be honest, so far with this game, I'm not too impressed. I mean, it's still kind of the introduction, and it's just starting off. Well, don't just stand there. It's just starting off still, and I haven't gotten all my abilities and such, but I've never been called an idiot before. Oh, she likes him. You looked a bit unkind back there. But you still do laugh in a cute way. Eh? Are you okay? Yes, I am fine. Pooh. That's the exit. Alright. Oh boy. Why is it just the one? And how did I get... Oh boy. And how did I get surprised? I walked right up to her. I was waiting. Now to truly defeat the magic knights. You heard Umi. Umi and Fu are my close friends. Hikaru! I see an attacks. Oh my god. Okay, she's gonna pick me off one by one here. Envelope in flames, shock with red lightning. I'll shock with red lightning. One damage, of course. Yep, she's gonna pick me off one by one. One damage. Oh, ho, ho, ho. I'm not really sure how that's supposed to be read. This is my true power. We won't lose. Hikaru? She's fighting with that woman. Hikaru, if I could use magic, I could help her. Magic didn't help me. Umi! I want magic. I want magic to save Hikaru. Pooh. Can you hear me, Umi? Clef? I'm speaking with you through Makona. You through Makona. Can you feel the power inside of you that you never had? Yes, words seem to come to my mind. That is your magic. Umi? Is something wrong? I'm gonna guess she's ice magic. Clef, he gave me magic. I can save Hikaru now. And this thing is weak to ice. I will go too. Wait. That magician is too much for you. Why aren't you calling me for help? Our agreement was to the forest exit. We cannot ask for any more. This is our fight. You here I go. Here I go, off to my death. Okay, so this appears to be a real fight now. So, we'll see how this goes. Yep, I can damage her. Let's see what magic. Ooh, dragon. Look like ice to me. Still with the lame ass attacks, though. Let's see what Red Bolt does. About the same. Another dragon. And my one hit point attack. Miss. Can't even give me the one hit point. Come on. The other one was better. Yeah, that's the strongest one I got. Good lord, this thing's got a lot of hit points. What good is the one shooting for one hit point? I don't understand that. Why can she not do decent damage? At least 50 or 60 or something. Something. Right now she's useless. I guess maybe, yeah, she's the token item. Oh shit, never mind. Damn. Yeah, that ain't gonna work when they're dead. I'm hoping this finishes her off. Oof. Well, that's luck. New spells. That's impossible. Umi. Now it's my turn. Pooh. Umi saved us with her magic. Now it is my turn to save Umi. Makona, give me magic. How does she know? Okay, so she's obviously going to be life magic. And she's going to get, like, resurrect or heal or something. But how does she know that? It's already inside of you. Your will to save your friends will guide you in your magic. My magic. And then she's acting surprised. She just asked for it. Don't forget. In Sephiro, your will determines your strength. Healing wind. Umi, you're all right. Are you still hurt? I'm fine, thank you. Actually, she's dead. Hikaru and Fu. Umi and Fu, you are my precious friends. For you two, I can do my best. Hikaru, thank you. You two are very special to me. The thought of saving Hikaru helped me learn how to use magic from now on. Let's put our strength together and do our best. You girls, you're the legendary magic knights. We weren't trying to hide it. You were right in doing that. You didn't know if I was on your side or not. We were summoned by Princess Emerald and came here. We met Clef and were asked to save the princess, who was kidnapped by Zagato. When the Pillar of Sephiro is in trouble, the summoned ones are to become the Magic Knights. The legend is true. That is the legend Clef and Persia we're talking about. A Sephira without Princess Emerald is in danger. The fears from those people have created the monsters. Then anxiety and fear have created those monsters? That's what he said. How do you know all of this? Who are you? I am an acquaintance of Princess Emerald. But first, Eterna is northeast of here. Be careful. Where are we going? Northeast. I thought I could become a legendary knight and get the escudo, but I'm going to let the real magic knights handle it. Ferio, I'll give you this. Who received an earring? But I don't have anything to give you in return. Ferio, thanks. I have received your thanks. That is enough. Let's meet again soon. Ferio left your party. What's his problem? He's a little snobbish, but cute. Foo, what's wrong? Nothing. It's nothing. Boy, that's a long trip northeast. Okay, so I got a ton of new spells I need to check out. Is this the Spring of Eterna? Where is the Escudo? Poo poo. Is he saying it's inside? If we need it to become magic knights, then let's go. If one can't do it, then the three of us together can. That's right. Just standing here won't get us anywhere. Here we go. Jump. Master Zagato, please forgive me. Oops. I didn't think they would have so much power. Next time I will defeat the Magic Knights, my beloved Master Zagato. Don't touch me. Oh. I beg of you one more chance. Get away, I do not need you anymore. No, Master Zagato. Inuva, you banished Alcyon without killing her? Let Ascot handle it next. There's so many names in this. Alcyon, hopefully she won't become the seed for misfortune. Ooh. Now see, this is what I was talking about earlier with the Dragon Warrior. If this lets me play different paths, that changes my whole view of this game. Let's see. Okay. That's cool. But is it just letting me play it till I get... yeah, back with the others? It's still cool. I love when games do stuff like this. Another world, hear my voice. Who's there? In this dungeon, you can't see everything using your eyes only. Hold strong feelings in your heart and search for the true reality. What you see is not always true. What does that mean? Who are you? The voice is gone. What did it mean by what you see is not always true? I'm gonna guess that I walk through those things. Those bubbles for walls or whatever they are. Distraction. Great. So confusion, not distraction. That's one thing I've never understood with some games, is the confusion spell or the confusion ability. I can understand confusion. I can understand if you're with, let's say, two other party members, and they cast confusion on you, and you hit one of your other party members. But what I can't understand about it is when you hit yourself. Because I don't care how confused I am in a battle, I know I'm not the enemy. I wouldn't hit myself. The whole concept is just silly. And I hope I have the items on this one. I hope they carry over. Because I feel I'm gonna have to heal with something before I am done with this. Oh. Crud. Come on. Star cube. Good thing I know what a star cube is. Okay, let's see what these are. Recover some magic points. Recover some hit points. Call for Fario's help. Ooh. Recover from paralyze and mute. Call for Fario's. Nope, wrong one. It jumped. Attack with firepower. Okay. Ooh, method speed fast. Window. Interesting. Oh, that's cool. Not that it makes a huge difference, but... And Makona. I can't use Makona because Makona isn't there. Aha! What the wall crumbled. Life cube. This game's a bit predictable. I guess it's even more so when you've played RPGs a lot and you kind of know what to look for, but this is really predictable, like what you have to do. Hitting myself again. Oh, see. Back here. Right there, those white dots. Okay, so the white dots are where the wall is fake. Boom. Gotcha. Wait, what did it? What happened? It didn't let me save. I can't save her. White dots. Nope. White dots. I saw him to the right, but okay. Want to make sure it's nothing over there. And it's just not, it's not very visually appealing, you know, like, these bad guys I'm fighting, like, are the same bad guys I fought earlier. Like, when you look at a game like Final Fantasy III, when they go through the effort of putting different bad guys for every single area, you know, and that's the same for most high-end RPGs. And Magic Knight Rayearth is actually a big name RPG, and I just kind of expect a lot going in, as far as, you know, the spells are kind of lackluster, the graphics for the spells, so far. I mean, that's usually how it kind of starts off, though, like with Final Fantasy III, even that. Fire 1 looks like crap, and then when you go further in, they look better, but I don't know, it just, the enemies are very, they're lacking in originality. They just don't, it's the same enemies so far, and the scenery is just god awfully ugly. Yeah, I'm thinking maybe what, is it the same exact game on Saturn? Like, story-wise and stuff? No? Okay. I was gonna say, what I could do is during the week while I'm offline sometime, I could just play the Saturn version and get to the back to the point where I'm at the next time I live stream. Oh, okay, the story's the same. Next time I live stream, I'll just play the Saturn version on a Saturn emulator and stream that instead. Because this just feels like it's missing something. Why are you attacking me? We were always friends. Why? Do you hate me now? Listen to my voice. That voice again. Who are you? Show yourself. Emerald. I am Emerald of Sephiro. Your Princess Emerald? Hold your heart strong and think, Magic Knight, is what you see in front of you something dear to you? Hikari is a precious friend. We have been together since I was little. Would something so precious attack you? Hikari wouldn't do such a thing, right? You're a fake. How dare you use Hikari's appearance? I gotta kill that dog. Kill my dog. What's that number at the bottom? I'm wondering. That's not the hit points, because I'm... Oh, well, it's mine. Where is it? Okay. I'm getting confused with the names, that's all. There's like 50 names, and this game just started barely. Hikari and Hikaru. Oh, Meteor. Let's check that one out. This is the same spot? Okay. Karu and Fu aren't here. What is this place? Hear my voice. Somebody there? In this dungeon, you can't see everything using your eyes only. Hold strong feelings in your heart and search for the true reality. What you see is not always true. What's that mean? Is the voice gone? What you see isn't always true? That all sounds familiar. Wall broke down. Yeah, they do that around here. Oh my god. Okay, so see different monsters, so that's a start. You know, I'm really dreading doing this part with that girl with the bow. Because she couldn't hit for shit. And I am getting beat down here. And not doing any damage. Magic only, probably. They'd be a little bit more lenient on the damage I'm taking when you have to figure out. Consuming water, covering a tsunami, ravaged with a tornado. Come on. Good. But I can't keep casting that. I hope I don't get into too many fights because that's going to take all my magic points. And of course, so it costs 3 for the dragon and 6 for tornado. Oh, and that hits both. Let's see. Ah. Well, then it's about the same because I have to cast that twice. I don't know what I'm going to do when I run out of magic mana. Oh, God. Doesn't it figure? Love when that happens. Love it. I mean, I kind of figured there was going to be one of those somewhere. But I didn't know how long it would be before they planted it. Son of a... I don't understand the turn order in this game either, because it just seems completely random. I'll hit twice in a row, they'll hit twice in a row. It doesn't seem like an actual turn order. And sometimes it'll be me attack, them attack, me attack, them attack. See, that's two turns. Like, is there not a RNG initiative roll before each fight or something? Is it just whoever goes, goes? Lifeful. Did not have those. That's good, I guess. Magic on these things just to get them out of the way, but I know I'm gonna need magic points later, so cast that, and I missed something there apparently, because it just used magic for some reason. Fighting these guys. I have items to get my mana back. Just use those when I need them. Oh, there's a chest though. Dark cubes. I'm betting there's something else to the left, but I'm not going over there. You know, now it makes me wish I would have played Super Dan instead. And don't get me wrong, I don't mind this game. It's actually not terrible. It's along the lines of Breath of Fire and the Fire type game. Not as well written, but it's along the same lines. Oh man, this is brutal. That voice, who are you? You're Princess Emerald. It's just the same text though. But I didn't repay them for raising me yet. I can't attack them. Would your real parents be happy listening to those words? I'm pretty sure. That's right. If I die here, then who will repay my parents? I can't lose here. Are they keeping tabs on how much it costed to raise her? Dressed in, like, okay, this is supposed to be like medieval time era or something in Japan. Why are these people dressed like in business attire with pumps on? Pretty sure that's not what they wore back then. Although they do have regular clothes on here. I mean, this game seems a little confused as to what time period it's in. You can't see everything using your eyes only. Hold strong feelings in your heart and search for the true reality. What you see is not always true. I wonder what that means. Probably the same thing it meant for the other two. What you see isn't always true. Okay. The wall fell down. Oh, freaky plant. Okay, so now she's doing some actual damage. Good. She had the life magic. A slice with a whirlwind. Blow with a fierce wind. So she got attack magic as well. That's good. So it looks like she's also got the most mana of all of them. She could very well turn out to be the best character. Now why doesn't it go through that one? It's too... Last one. Surprised, of course. Okay, wow, this girl is so full of herself. Oh boy. So I hit this thing and it hurts me? Is that how this fight's gonna happen? Calm yourself. I am precious to myself. The way I am happy is through my parents' love. The only way to answer that is to be truly happy. Then the people who I love, who love you, expect you to be alive. Yes, my wounds can be fixed with magic later. My family will worry if anything happens to me. Okay. See what happens when I heal myself. I was thinking maybe it would damage her, but... No. Of course not. Looks like I'm in the nick of time. The light. This is, could it be, the legendary mineral? Good job, you three. Persea, why are you here? To make the Magic Knight's weapons as soon as possible. Using all my power for the best weapons. And they're going to be exactly the same as the weapons I have now, I'll bet. So they're wearing clothes now. Oh, swords. Cool. The escudo is changing into a sword. Those are the Magic Knight's weapons. Only one set in this world. Made especially for you. return the borrowed weapons. Persea. I'm fine, only a little exhausted. What are those armors? They changed all of a sudden. They look a lot more beautiful than before. It's something Clef gave you, right? The armor that grows, like those weapons. These weapons will grow too? Right, they will change with the strength of the wielder's willpower. I wanted you to be strong and crafted those weapons with that will. Now it's your willpower which will make them grow. Thanks, Persea. Thanks, pal. To become magic knights, you'll need to revive the Mashin. Go to the southern seashore. Makona will know the way to the shrine. But I'm worried about you, Persea. I'll be fine, and that food you gave me, it was delicious. The candy, right? I think I had one more. Not now. When you come back safely, I'll have it then. Persea, okay. We'll make the weapons grow and promise to come back. When I return, I'll bake you a cake. I'll be waiting. Thank you very much. Good luck, Karo, Umi, Fu. Persea, thank you so much. Okay, come on, get on with it. Jeez. This is like the ending of Lord of the Rings from the uncut version. Just go. Please protect those girls. Okay. Ooh, yeah, that's good damage. Except for that. That's a miss. This is actually pretty cool. Did you get to have your own little thing there? Oh, really? Okay, I think that's gonna do it for me tonight. It's getting late. Gotta wake up early. But I'm gonna pick up on this game. And like I said, next week. And like I said, if you're not following Retro Humanoid on Facebook or Retro Humanoid on Twitter, go ahead and do that, and then it'll notify you when I'm live, and it'll also give you a heads up on when the new stuff is coming out for the arcade things that I'm doing. But yeah, have a good night.